Hi, it's Melissa from the Manor Library, and this is the last week of Oceans of Possibilities, and this week we are looking at a water bead stress ball. It has been the favorite by far of everybody who's been in the library to check out our sample crafts. So come in this week, pick it up while supplies last. This is what you're going to get. You have a bottle of water, and then it's going to have a bag taped to it. Inside the baggie are these teeny tiny little beads and a balloon. This one is super easy, but it does take a little bit of time. Not really hands-on time, but it does take some time. Take the baggie and dump the beads into a mixing bowl. I would say make it at least a 4-cup mixing bowl. You don't want to overflow this. And then just set the balloon aside. Dump the entire contents of the water bottle in with the beads and let it set overnight. I think the instructions say at least 4 hours. I just did this last night and then I didn't have to worry about it. Keep the empty bottle. And then in the morning, your beads are gonna be a whole lot bigger than they were at the start. So take your beads and you want to feed them into the empty bottle. This is not as hard as it sounds. I just took some into my hand and then you can just kind of shove them in there. Okay? And then once that is full, we can just finish making our stress ball. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna stretch the balloon over the top of the bottle, kind of like this. And then you're just gonna squeeze the water balls into the balloon. You may not use all of them. When I did these last night, I even had too many water balls to even fit into the plastic water bottle. Okay, when you think you have enough, just pull the balloon off. Easier said than done. Pull the balloon off. There we go. Balloon is off, and then just tie a knot like you would tie a balloon. It is super simple, super easy. I make no promises about staying mold free, but I made mine at the beginning of summer and I still don't have any ickies in it. So this should be something you can play with for a nice long time. They are non-toxic. Obviously you don't want to eat them, but they are non-toxic, so your little guys can use them. And this is how many leftover I had that didn't fit in the bottle. You can always play with those separately. So hope you have fun with it. Come down, pick one up. Like I said, they're here free. If you haven't turned your log in, please turn those in as well as soon as you can, so that Miss Stephanie and I can draw prize winners and print up certificates and figure out your goodie bags and all that. I hope you had a fun summer with us, and we'll see you at the library this fall.